second part of the action plan will focus on our quality of life and amenities that enhance our lifestyle in Sault Ste. Marie. When I was first elected in 2000, the economy needed so much attention that little else mattered. Now, as we continue to grow and attract people, our quality of life is key. I've worked particularly hard in this area, bringing the idea of the city assisting in physician recruitment in 2001 to City Council, leading the support on the expansion of our post-secondary institutions, including the IT Center at Algoma University, and supporting the expansion of the Hub Trail. And of course, being the leader on the building of the SR Center, the committee chair. But there's more to do. The boardwalk and Hub Trail could be expanded. In a vibrant community, one expects all your amenities, your rinks, your libraries, all your facilities, hopefully an indoor soccer facility. In the coming years, our college and university will need our full support. When it comes to quality of life, nothing is more important than dependable health care. You have my commitment that the city will do anything within our role to improve on this. Lastly, the third component, we'll outline a plan for City Hall and the important services we provide. Often this is overlooked in an election, but the core responsibilities of a municipality are the ones that you depend on daily. Your fire, your police, your garbage, pickup, snow removal. The city must provide these to you efficiently. The challenge is providing them at a tax rate that is affordable. That needs to be done. Unless these challenges at City Hall will not be achieved unless the mayor and council are working as a team. Accomplishments will only happen with individuals working together. The specific details of the community action plan will be put forth to you and all residents in the coming months. I've summarized many initiatives tonight. We will achieve these goals, but it doesn't happen if you don't have the leadership to deliver it. I just want to deviate just a second. Today I was at two city invitations. You know, I was at Superior Heights, the new high school. And at one point in the presentation, they had all the students that were going to attend the new high school stand up. And there was many of them. Then they had all the elementary students that may attend the school stand up. And when you see all these kids, these children of our community, and this $47 million investment that they're making for the future of our community, it was great to see. Then from there, at 1 o'clock, we had a short line rail meeting at City Hall. And we have challenges with the rail from Sault Ste. Marie to Sudbury, and we have all the municipalities working on it. It's complicated, but we're working on solutions. And two meetings today, each on different ends of the spectrum. But I can tell you that I love it. I really have a passion for it. I want to serve you. I want to keep serving the community. And we've made so much progress in the last 10 years I've been on council that we need to continue on. And that's why a campaign race cannot be taken lightly. This next story is my last story. I told this story in 1999 during my first political speech I ever delivered. I was describing an election race. It was two hikers, they're walking through a forest. And way in the distance of the trail, a bear jumps out. And this bear, it looks mean and it's hungry. And one of the hikers turns to leave. And he looks down, and the fellow hiker, he's on the ground, he's tying his shoes. And he looks down at him and he says, what are you doing? You're not going to outrun the bear. And the fellow looks up at him and says, I don't need to outrun the bear, I just have to outrun you. Well, folks, that's what we're going to have. It will be a race, and it will be contested. And I'll need your help and support to win this race. And together we can do it. I've talked to many here and other supporters, and some have said, you know, Jamie, I'm really busy, I've got two kids in hockey. The weather's always crummy for an election. I'll probably get bit by a dog helping you. What's in it for me? And people ask that often. What's in it for me? What's in it for the community? You know, I could tell you that as mayor, you'll get my best. And the bar is high in this community, and you'll have my commitment that I'll serve you in Sault Ste. Marie to those high expectations. You know, you all have different reasons for being here. Some of you think of your kids, you know, and your grandkids, and you say you want a prosperous city, so they have a place, they have a future in Sault Ste. Marie, close to where you live. And some of you, you have businesses, and you have a huge financial investment or stake in our community, and you want a prosperous city so that investment is protected. And other people, you want our tax base to grow so we can provide services or lower the tax rate or provide amenities and facilities to the community. But, you know, we all have one thing in common, everyone in this room. We care about the community, and we care about the future. And together, we can do something about it. The next election is important to all of us. We all have so much invested in our community. So I very much appreciate you being here and supporting me tonight. Now that I've hopefully inspired you, and that I've hopefully have you committed, I don't want you to worry that I need you for the next 8.5 months. I know what's on the back of everybody's mind. But your help in the months or weeks prior to the election is truly, truly appreciated. This announcement has been the culmination of a decade for me of hard work and community service. And to be able to share this announcement with you here tonight is very special to me. So I thanked a lot of people tonight, but I also want to thank you for coming and supporting me. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Feel free to stay. There's refreshments and there's coffee in the back. And feel free to stay and thanks for coming.